objects, yeah, let's go about creating. You've already seen like that we create a string or a scanner using a new keyword and an array as well. Well, that's basically you're telling Java, hey, I would need some place in memory to store something, you know. And in Java, like you only have 5, 7, something like that, primitive types. All the other types are objects. So we're going to be creating some objects on, of our own today, just to show you how that's done. And let's do that now. What we're going to do is we're going to create a new class, right click here, new Java class, or the shortcut is Alt Insert. But again, right click, new Java class. You pick here what you want it to be. You want it to be a class, and we're going to name it dog. And what's dog supposed to be? Well, it's a template for something that in real life, you all know what a dog is in real life. But this class, we're going to create a couple more classes just to show you how they're used. But the thing is, we want to save some data about a dog or a person or a computer or a speaker, whatever. You know, you have some tasks in real life, like, I don't know, give me a list of all students. Well, what are students? Well, they have a name and they have their, I don't know, teacher, and they have the address and whatever you want to save about them. And how would you do that without a custom data type? Well, if I were to tell you save a student, you would have to do something like string name equals Milan, and then like you would have to say, I don't know, int age equals 28, and I don't know, some other data that you want to save. Like you can imagine if I had like 3 or 4 or 5 pieces of data, but now I want to add another student. Well, I have to copy all this and say name 2, age 2, and so on. And to create another student, I mean, and this is all over the place. And we would, I mean, how do I know which age is connected to which name? These are really independent pieces of data. So why not put all of them in one class and have something like this? Have a dog which has a name. So let's say string name, and let's say, I don't know, string breed of the dog. I don't know many breeds, you guys will help me out with that. And let's say int age. So now all the dogs that we create are gonna have these three pieces of data. And we've just created some custom data type of our own. This is the data type for all the dogs. So now when we're saving dogs, we can say dog.name equals something like Rover. And then we can say dog.breed equals, I don't know, Husky. And then we can say dog1.age equals something like 3. And now when we want to access something from the dog one, it's all contained there in the dog one variable. If we want to create another dog, dog two equals new dog. And now we can do the same thing for the other dog. We can say dog two equals something, something. Oops, dog two. This one is old and he's called Oldie, I don't know. And he's like golden. Oops. Oh my God. Golden retriever. Okay. And why is this here and not here? Okay, so now we can create as many dogs as we want, and we can have an array of dog. Like we can have literally like a dog array called dogs, which is equal to new, or let's just put both dogs inside of it, dog one, dog two. And you can now see why this is useful. Now we have a dog array. We have an array of dogs. We can have an array of anything. We can have all the dogs in one place. We can create more dogs, add them here. We can print out the names of all dogs. We know what's where, you know, which dog has what. I mean, there's no confusion. If all of these were just variables on their own, I mean, there's no, we wouldn't be able to know for sure what belongs where, you know. So now we can create a loop and print out the names of our dogs. So let's go like dogs.length. And we're going to say, what are we doing? We're doing print out the dogs of I, but that's a dog. So when we put a dot here, we have all the things that the dog has here, like name, right? And if we run this now, Rover, Aldi. Okay, So now you can do all kinds of things with this. For example, if you had a veterinary shop and you would have like a million dogs in here, let's just create another dog three. And I just want to show you another alternative way of creating the dog. We can have something that's called a constructor. This thing can have parameters. We don't have to just have the empty thing here. I mean, for now, this empty constructor, it's called a constructor because we're constructing a new thing, right? And it's provided by default, but we can provide our own constructor. We can say public dog and then open parentheses. And this would be our constructor. Why is it public? Because everybody needs to access it. I mean, I could just leave it empty, but it's usually public because if you want your class to be able to be used by everyone, just put public. If you don't want your class to be able to be used by everyone, you can just put like something else here. We will talk about that as well. But now I can say, hey, string, pass me the name. So name one, string breed one, string age one. And I'll tell you why I called them with one. And then we will not do that again. So now we can say name equals name one and do the same for breed and do the same for age. Okay. And this should be an integer, right? Okay. So now we basically said, oh, hey, when creating a dog, you have to provide these three parameters, right? It's not going to be empty. We need these three parameters in order to initialize our three variables, right? So now it says two problems. Well, the problems are, of course, here when we're creating a dog, we can no longer just leave this empty. So now let's just create the dog properly. Let's do Rover. He's a husky and he's three. And now all of these lines just become one way simpler line, right? And we will get rid of all this and we will call this one Marcy. I don't know many dog names. Golden Retriever, and she's gonna be 12. And now you can see how this is useful. Well, all of that code just went into two lines and there's a couple more lines here, right? So basically we can create many, many dogs and let's do a veterinary shop, something like that. Yeah, we access them the same way. Each dog calls the constructor, calls this method, and each dog has its own set of variables. Like these variables, the name belongs to one particular instance of this class. And that's a really important thing. Now I'm gonna probably cover a bit more than is contained in this lesson. So maybe I will repeat myself in the future, but this is really important. All of these, they belong to a single dog. If you remember when I talked about static things don't belong to one particular dog. They belong to all the dogs. So if I create static variable here, I don't know what would be static. What would be common to all the dogs, like other than four legs? Let's say like, I don't know, integer int number of legs, num of legs equals four. So now, okay, let me show you this in the example. That's the best way. Let's call this one doggy. That's wrong. So doggo, something like that. I don't know, he's a regular retriever. I think that exists as well. Let's do like he's 10. Okay, and yeah, let's add doggo to the dog list as well. The point here now that I wanna illustrate is if we change the dog one's name, we say dog one.name, let's do that before printing out the names. So dog one.name equals no longer Rover, whatever. This will affect only the change to his name, basically to his variable name, right? But let's print out before that, let's do s out dog one dot, let's do dog dot number of legs. So as you can see, I cannot even access number of legs from the dog because it doesn't belong to one dog. If I start typing dog one dot num of, Java is complaining here because it's like you can access it, but it's not smart to access it. I mean, we can do this, but it doesn't work the other way around. We cannot access non-static things from the static. This does make sense. So let me just try to explain it this way. So every dog has a name and a breed and an age. So a separate name, a separate breed, and a separate age. And number of legs is a variable shared between all dogs. So basically, yes, you can access it from one particular dog, but you, if you change it, that will affect the change for all the dogs in the dog class, right? So if I do number of legs dot equals 5 here on dog 1, and I system out print line afterwards, dog 2 dot number of legs, what do you think would happen? Let's run this and check out the output. Okay, so the thing is here, as you can see, when changing the name of one particular dog, so we this one was Rover and now his name is no longer Rover, that only affected his name. Other names remained independently unchanged, right? But when we changed the dog 1 dot number of legs to 5, and we've previously printed out dog number of legs as it was 4 previously, so that's 4 here, and then we printed it out on dog 2 number of legs, it affected that change as well. That's the difference between static and non-static things. Static things belong to the whole class. There's only one variable for the whole class, okay? And non-static variables, they belong to the particular instance of a class, right? So there's a copy of these variables for each dog that we create, and there's only one of this, okay? And how is this useful? Well, let's create a veterinary shop real quick. So let's not do number of legs. Let's do, I don't know, like order number or ID of the dog. And we will start off at 1. So whenever we create a new dog, we want to give him a unique ID. Static variables can be changed. And that's the thing. I'm going to show you right now how this is useful. We have the ID in our veterinary shop, for example. Let's leave number of legs just an example of something that we're not going to change very often, but let's have an ID, and let's have each dog have its own ID. So int dog ID, something like that. When we're creating a dog, of course, we do not need to provide dog ID. We're going to create that on our own. We only need to know the name, the breed, and the age, right? So dog ID is going to be equal to the ID. And then we increase ID for the next dog that comes in. And what does this do? Well, since this variable is shared between all dogs, it'll be 1 for the first one, and then it gets increased to 2. And then when we're creating another dog, he will have his ID as 2, and so on, because they all share this variable. We can keep track of how many dogs we have using that, right? That's one of the useful things about a static thing. It's there for the whole class. So if we start off at 1, when we create the first dog, he will have his own dog ID. Of course, you do understand the difference between this and this. This belongs to the class. This belongs to one particular dog, right? So if we change the variable that belongs to the whole class will have the new value. You know, it'll be 2 and 3 and so on. But each dog will have its own ID. So now when we're printing the dogs here, let's do like the dogs of I dot dog ID plus a space and the name of the dog. Let's get rid of number of legs. Let's get rid of this. Okay. And let's leave this guy to be named Rover. So if we run this now, this is our dogs. Like Rover's dog ID is 1, Marcy's dog ID is 2, this one's dog ID is 3. And what would be the value if we print out the dog dot number of legs here? What's the value of number of, no, not number of legs, not that, some, the ID is what I wanted to print out. It's 4. It would be ready for the next dog. Since we already added 3 dogs, if you see here in the constructor, after adding a dog, we always increase the ID to be ready for adding the next dog, right? So that one is 4. And that one belongs to the whole class. And if you can see here, I accessed it actually using the class name. I didn't say dog 1.id. Whenever you access it using the variable name, it says static member accessed via instance reference. Basically, this is a warning. It's not an error. You can do this, but it makes much more sense since it belongs to the class to access it using the class name, right? Dog is the class name. The ID is the static variable that belongs to the class. So that's how we can access it. We can also access it via the variable, but I mean, it makes just a little bit more sense to do it like this. Okay.